Okay, for the enterprise-wise, for the year of 2013, we have achieved this $2.5 billion revenue. Okay, and this year we also have a target. I think yesterday our David Her has informed you of that target we have already released. It's 3.5, I think, right? $3.5 billion the target. And that is, you know, general of the revenue. And in terms of the geography kind of, we have, actually because eBeach Enterprise Business Group is just one business group of Huawei. Actually, we also have like device and carrier. So the both of the three BGs were at the same platform, which is Huawei's platform. I mean, we have more than 100 countries. And we have these representative offices across the globe, more than 100 countries as well. And for eBeach, because we have this strategy of, how to say, focus, okay? So especially for eBeach business, we're focusing on some of these areas, you know? Because that's a saying, because enterprise business means where there are business of enterprise, there are business enterprise, right?
Right.
Okay.
Yesterday, a Huawei executive told Brazilian journalists that you have a $10 billion US dollars target for, I don't know how many years, I guess 5 years from now.
2017. Yes.
Could you disclose it a little bit further? And what are you based on this this growth? Is there any particular era or product or?
Okay, so if you calculate, yes, it's for sure because our Eric Xu, I think our rotable CEO, he also again stated this year, April, at our GAS event, 2017, we will have $10 billion US dollar of enterprise business growth. Okay, I think in terms of that, you can see the CAGR, CAGR of the growth rate of EBG business, we have is almost 40. Almost 40, right? 40% every year since 2011. So eBeach was established in 2011. Okay, so from 2011 to 2012, and from 2012 to 2013, every year almost we get this almost 40% of the CAGR growth. Okay, so if you calculate, well, I think in terms of the trends, we follow these very hot topics like big data, okay, cloud computing. And also like SDN, okay, virtualized, you know, virtualized of everything, this trend. So for that's why I think I think as per Eric Xu's speech yesterday, he also mentioned cloud computing is the chance for Huawei to enter this IT. Okay, actually we started this IT product line from the cloud computing product line. So the previously the former product line of IT product line was cloud computing product line. So we started this, we consider cloud computing is very very important one, you know, is kind of chance for Huawei. So that's why we have this cloud congress. And in terms of the so this is a very important trend. Okay, and based on this trend, and after several years of development. Now we have lots of this, you know, cutting-edge kind of technology and products. Okay, I think for these 2 days you already goes through some of that, right? Mm-hmm. So this is one of the cloud computing. We have the very important one is our platform, software platform. We have our own developed kind of cloud platform, FusionSphere. Okay, FusionSphere. So for the FusionSphere, and now I think yesterday we launched this FusionSphere 5, version 5, right? So for the version 5, I mean, if you look back, okay, of the FusionSphere before, so the system is becoming more and more open, okay, more and more open, and we are fully OpenStack based, okay, more and more open, and we have more and more, you know, integrated with our partners. We have lots of interfaces and to integrate with the partners kind of upper level application. Upper level. When that's upper level applications, that means the you know, lots of applications in the industry. Give you one example of like the media cloud application. So I just come here from the one of our developer forum. So for the medium cloud ones, so they need, you know, they have previously for the they have several steps, right? For the media's kind of processing, first they have to take the video shooting, then they pre-processing it, okay, and they have a different kind of, you know, the workstation, and they have to transfer this videos from one station to another one, right? Mm-hmm. So previous this kind of transformation is very, you know, very low efficiency, mm-hmm. and now they are fully based on the cloud one, so it's improved their efficiency a lot. You know, both this pre-processing staffs and the later ones, they can working on the same cloud platform, so greatly improved their efficiency. And for this application, what we provide is our infrastructure. We have our storage, okay, and we have our server, and have a data center, and we have also provide our vision sphere, is our cloud platform, okay, for this virtualization and the management of the VM and the management of the data center, like the managed one. The managed one is also one of our very important one of our software part for the management. So for this application, this is what we provide. And besides this, we cooperate with Sobei, S-O-B-E-Y. Okay, that is one of our very, very important partner in the media, in the omni-channel media domain. Okay, they provide is this the video processing softwares. Okay, for the Shenzhen TV, and as well as also for the other TV stations. So this, I just give you one example of this.
Yeah. Is there any particular vertical that you are focusing on, or what kind of industry you are going to, do you think the biggest money or the largest amount of money is going to come
That's
from?
Good question. Okay, we do have our frequency industry, yes. I mean, currently the biggest one for us, the industry, is the government as well as the public sectors, when I say the government and public sectors. Yeah. Why we consider this very important? Because, you know, like smart city, it's really a very huge, big range. And the solutions what we can provide for the smarter city include like the safe city. If you ever been to our exhibition hall, you see that, right? So we have that command center in our showcase, right? That is for the safe city. And for the safe city, we also cooperate with partner like Hexagon. If you know that, Hexagon, H-E-X-G-O-N, H-E-X-G-O-N, yeah. It is one of the global partner for Huawei for this safe city. So for Hexagon, they provide is the cooperation between different departments, or collaboration between different departments. Because for the safe city, one of the challenges for safe city is, all right, so if there is any kind of, you know, crime, right, or the policeman, okay, the first one, the policeman is fine. However, if there any accident, we also need some other departments, right, like the clinical, right, and also some the other departments. So Hexagon, they provide is this kind of application across different departments, okay, and also they provide a GIS, kind of geography information system, GIS, okay, system, and based on the geography, and I think they also acquire the kind of a company who can provide this a maps kind of based application. So this is Hexagon, our partner. And what Huawei provide for this safe city? So we provide, firstly, we can provide this ELTE-based kind of multimedia trunking. Okay, this is a broadband multimedia trunking system.
You said ELTE?
Yes, ELTE, yeah. I think the small letter, right?
Smaller.
Yeah, small letter E. Three bigger ones, ELTE. Mm-hmm. So the ELTE Huawei, I think, is one of the leading vendor in the world to provide this real kind of a multimedia broadband trunking system. Yeah. And yesterday we also shooting some other application like ELTE for Netherlands. This is our another partner, VCS. VCS observation. So VCS observation partner with Huawei provides this ELTE based safe city for Netherlands as well. Okay, so this is SIF City. Besides this ELTE multimedia kind of a trunking system for the smart city, we also have another ones like e-government, okay, the government cloud, okay, and also some unified communication based kind of collaboration application. So this is for the, that's why we consider government, okay, asking a question, talking along. Now coming next, also when I say public sector, also include like education, so this is all the broader kind of meaning of government. And besides this one, also we have other ones like transportation, financial, FSI, financial, okay, industry, the energy, especially like electricity, mm-hmm. And the say that some large enterprise, right? Some large enterprise, including the media, the omnichannel media, okay. So this is all our kind of vertical ones, yeah. So besides vertical ones, we do have some others like, okay. There's another also very important one. I think is our telecom sector, yeah. That is one of the Huawei strengths, yeah, because for globally, lots of these telecoms operator, they are also doing their business on enterprise. Yeah. So because Huawei is quite a leading in the telecom sector, so we partner with telecom to provide enterprise solution for the end user. And also some commercial, the real kind of commercial markets as well.